Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and a very good evening to all seeing this video. Late, but I think Tata Motors Limited quarter 3 results I think was pretty good, but on a valuation perspective also I just want to speak about it. And one more factor, how could budget affect this share momentum? Okay, let us see all those factors and then move to this main important thing. So this is the so-called standalone results. So this time we are going to compare both standalone as well as consolidated. So standalone, as we know, consolidated, we know, right? The JLR. So I think all this process and we are going to check it. Okay, so which means basically the operating revenue has been increased from 9500 crore to 14500 crore. So sequentially, if you see, there's a large growth if you compare quarter on quarter. And also if we compare the total profit before exceptional items, the loss has been reduced. Yes, on a standalone basis, the company has made loss. But we must understand here one thing, the total loss is coming in the range of around total comprehensive income for the period is around 437 crores is the loss. But if you compare year on year as well as quarter on quarter, there is a sequential decrease in the loss. This is as per standalone basis. But if we go to see this consolidated basis, I think the numbers, what you are going to see, I think you will blow your mind, because I think those results, I think, are very very good, because finally I think it is reviving from its low end back. I think one of the reasons why I started to cover Tata Motors as a consolidated basis, because I just want to say the commercial vehicle segment is going to revive, that it could provide a good contribution to this. Okay, as you can see here, revenue has increased from 52,000 crores to almost 75,000 crores this time. And other income has been in the range of around 712 crores. Okay, that is a manageable level. So what has basically happened? The Tata Motors has produced a revenue which is exceeded the pre-COVID levels of the previous year. And the net profit after all these kind of expenses is coming in the range of around 4,590 crores. If you compare quarter on quarter, if you compare year on year, both has beaten it, okay? And net profit after all these exceptional items coming in the range of around profit or loss for the continuing operation is around 3,200 crore. But if you add or rate the other comprehensive incomes for the investment they hold, it's coming around 6,438 crore. So instead of seeing the 6,438 crore, you should only see the total profit or loss for the continuing operation. I think maybe you can see 3,200 crore or profit or loss for the period 2,941 crore. So almost posting a profit of around 3,000 crore this quarter versus 300 crores loss previous quarter. After three quarters, Tata Motors had made a comeback. I think this result is going to define one of the main factors. And apart from this, I'm going to focus on one more thing, is that why the company has made losses due to borrowings. So let us see one of the media results what this company has mainly said to us. Okay, and basically they have allotted some shares to Tata Sons Private Limited, and that is one of the factors they're saying. So Tata Motors consolidated results, strong all-round performance is definitely revenue growth, EBITDA growth, profit before tax. I think if you compare Reliance profitability and their market capital, and if you compare Tata Motors with their market capital to their performance, you know the difference, right? Yes. So here I just want to make sure one thing, I just see, because their electrified option extended to 12 JLR models, so which means they are becoming electrification. I also saw, right, I think December 2010 sales in Jaguar Land Rover, half of the sales was contributed by EV electronic vehicles. And also, you know that I think Tata Motors is a market leader in India in electronic vehicle segment. I think if they can continue their scope of going, I think it's going to be very, very important. And there was a buzz around Tesla and Tata Motors joining hands. I think that boom actually went off. But there can be chances or there may not be chances, because both have declined that they are not any things like that. So we cannot able to over exaggerate that thing. And business highlights and their commercial vehicle as well as passenger vehicle segment are showing a growth. And we must note here one thing, if the commercial vehicle segment is going to turn around, a good thing, is going to be very, very important. As you can see here, the finance cost has increased by 382 crore this quarter alone to 206 during the quarter. We are due to higher gross borrowings, but I already explained to you, they have confirmed that within 3 years from there saying Tata Motors will be debt free. So which means basically the extra tax, mean extra say so called interest burden which they have suffered these 20 days would be attributable into a profitable region for our shareholders. And now the final point of you want to discuss, how much the share can go from here. I think almost the share has doubled. I think mainly I said to my friend focusing on this commercial vehicle segment, and my friends know, right? Tractor India Limited, Tata Motors, VBR. I just only said Tata Motors VBR. I never said Tata Motors Limited, because I believe if any crash is going to come, Tata Motors DVR could not be hammered down a lot. And third thing could be Wheels India, and fourth thing is Revati Equipment. I think all these companies, if the commercial vehicle segment is going to revive, is going to be very, very important. And tomorrow's budget, if government is going to decide to improve this infrastructural activities, then commercial vehicle segment sales could definitely improve. If commercial vehicle sales are going to definitely improve, all the automobile spare parts company related to this commercial vehicle segment could definitely improve. So it basically depends upon how much further valuation this Tata Motors Limited is going to go. I believe one day Tata Motors Limited could reach 1 lakh crore of market capital. I think it is achievable, but I think it could take time, and it should take time, because if the share is going to jump like a rocket, okay, like 250 rupees today, 300 rupees today, 350 rupees tomorrow, then the price could not be sustainable. And we have already seen many great companies falling like a crap right now after we have spoken about it. But Tata Motors, I think the group as a whole, Tata, I think when they say, when they commit, I think they will do it. And I think they are doing it, but I always say one quarter performance is not enough. We want a continuous performance, and I hope if that is going to the case, I think they will be definitely focusing on this electronic vehicle segment. And second thing, they will also focus to improve this commercial vehicle segment. And already the passenger vehicle segment is going good. Now they want to focus on this electronic vehicle segment as well as this so-called commercial vehicle segment. And with it, I think everything is placed correctly. They can easily reduce their debt and enhance the shareholders' value. And I think as a long-term friends who have already loaded their shares in Tata Motors Limited and Tata Motors DVR, I think almost you have been gaining the percentage of around 70 to 100%, depending upon your price you enter. So any dip, I think there could be a buying opportunity. Why? Because whatever price you may buy right now, your average price would be less than the market price. So which means basically your margin of safety is great. So let us hope that any correction could come in the market, which could give a buying opportunity for Tata Motors also. Don't anticipate big moves, because I think even though having these great results, I think budget is starting at 11 a.m. tomorrow, because budget is more important than the share, individual share price momentums. Because a good result could be affected by budget in a bad way. A bad result company could be affected in a positive way by the budget. So basically depends upon one of few events. So let us leave this so-called things, but I believe one day Tata Motors Limited could achieve 1 lakh crore of market capital. Thank you friends, and bye.